Welcome to Esper Console under 10 minutes. In this video, we will walk through how you can leverage Esper to deliver exceptional customer experiences and accelerate your digital transformation as an IT professional. You might ask, why Esper? Esper is the first platform for an agile approach to Android device deployment. Esper is a full stack of solutions to empower your business. Esper helps you take control of the Android lifecycle, even when you are deploying a mix of devices. Today, we will work with Andy to accomplish their goals. Andy is an IT professional who works at a healthcare company. Their business goal is to improve healthcare access and reduce patients' costs. As a company, they are on a mission to transform from traditional healthcare to telehealthcare in the next 2 years. Seeing Esper is helping other healthcare players on the market manage their devices remotely. Andy started to evaluate it and found that it is not only powerful but also very customer-centered. Now, as an IT professional, Andy wants to reduce the long waiting times in front of the reception desk by setting up patient check-in kiosk devices. Let's see how Esper is helping Andy succeed. After logging into Esper Console as a user, you will land on the dashboard. Console is a single stop for provisioning, managing, and maintaining a fleet of devices. Everything UI-based happens here. You will see more details about the device on the dashboard page, like device statuses, device security, alerts, device locations, and recent pipelines. So the first step of provisioning devices is creating a group under the devices and groups section for organized management. Navigate to the devices and groups. Drag and expand the group section to see all the options. Click on the plus icon next to the all devices to create a higher level group. You need to give your group a name that is meaningful for your use case. For Andy's case, let's name it Andy's Healthcare. Click add group. After creating the group, go to the provisioning templates section to set the configurations for your group of devices. Select create template. Give it a name and click next. The compliance policy is a set of configurations that will be applied to all the devices provisioned through the template. It will be pre-populated with some default settings. Here we want to address device security since it is crucial for the telehealth company. We will enable Android Debug Bridge, ADB, to allow device communication. When done, select next. In the app section, since the devices will be implemented as check-in kiosks, let's choose kiosk mode. You can upload apps from your local machine or Google Play Store. I will select the apps from Esper Apps. Select the application and choose the app version. Add application. Now it will download the app to the devices during provisioning. When done, click next. Now we get to the device's settings. Like Wi-Fi connection and GPS, controlling the wallpaper and sound, etc. It enables you with JSON as well. When done, click Next. Now we need to assign this template to a specific group of devices. Here we choose to apply the template to all the devices in the group, Andy's Healthcare. Click Next. Preview it. If it looks good, select Save, Confirm. Finally, it's time for provisioning the kiosk devices. Esper offers multiple provisioning methods under the Provisioning Method section. Let's try Esper's 6-tap QR code. Follow the step-by-step instruction. Select the template you want to apply to your devices, then view QR code. As you can see two screens here, the one on the left is showing the console page and the one on the right is showing your device. If you tap 6 times on your device, you will see the camera is activated, waiting for you to scan the QR code displayed on the console page. When done, give it 15 seconds to provision. It may take longer due to different network bandwidths, app sizes, etc. It is running perfectly, but after a while, Andy noticed that it is confusing for the patients to navigate everything on a single kiosk and they ask for help from the staff on the floor even more often. Maybe separating the kiosk devices based on their functions will be simpler for patients to use. Esper will help Andy to do just that. This will require creating subgroups under the parent group, Andy's Healthcare. Click on the plus icon to create a subgroup. Give it a name that fits the use case. Here we need to set some devices to handle payments. Next is to apply a template to the payment group. To better organize the devices and save time, instead of creating a brand new template for the subgroup, let's duplicate its parent group's template so we only need to change several specific configurations. Click on the ellipsis, then select Edit. Rename it Payment. Go to the App section. Clear the original check-in app and add the payment app. Since everything else stays the same, you can click Preview to fast forward to the end. Select Update. Now we can provision payments devices to this subgroup. Voila! We have successfully organized, configured, and started to manage all of Andy's kiosk devices using groups and templates. One bonus tip for you to remotely control your kiosks in the field. At any time, you can navigate to see the details of provision devices, access the remote reviewer, and click Start Session. You will see the screen of that device. Esper establishes a secure connection with the device for you to remotely troubleshoot the device, so that Andy's team will use these remote viewer and control features to save on operations costs, as they don't need to dispatch people into the field as frequently as before. Now, let's take a look at the app section. Here, you can manage and add more apps to your console tenant. Similarly, you have the option to upload files to the console under the content management section. You can transfer these files, such as configuration files, images, certificates, or other file formats, to individual devices and device groups. The next stop is Esper API keys that can automate the developer's workflow. Esper APIs are a set of REST-based APIs that help you programmatically control and monitor Android-based dedicated devices running the Esper agent using the Esper console. In order to use these APIs, you need to navigate to the API key management section to find your enterprise ID and create an API key. These are the two fields that are needed for authentication. As the developers are working on automating the workflows, Andy gets complaints about patients waiting in long lines and saying one of the kiosks is not working. Esper offers a lot of reporting and alert capabilities to diagnose each device. Let's see what the issue is on that specific device. Under the report section, you can export reports by clicking View or Downloading. You can also navigate to a single device and see more details. Let's go into this device and check its device graph. The malfunction is due to a drop in battery level. But what should we do to prevent this from happening again? Under the alert section, create alert. Choose alert type battery, give it a name. Then set the alert condition and report to, for example, an IT specialist through email, and set the alert at your chosen frequency on the chosen device. Preview it. If it looks good, save it. There, you just secured yourself from unalerted low battery issues in the future. Andy heard that Esper is releasing a new version next week. This is concerning because Andy's team wants to test the new update before deploying it to all their devices. They want to make sure their customers don't have any interruptions. Under the Esper Software Update section, you can control when and how the updates are deployed. All the latest versions are presented here. It gives you the flexibility to stay up to date with Esper software by testing an update version in the pipeline. What is Esper Pipeline? It helps automate the smooth completion of actions on large fleets of devices by testing the update first on a small group of devices, and then run the update on all the devices. You can never be too cautious about updates, right? Here at Pipeline Stage 1, select the first group of devices you want to test it on, and continue. Click Run. Now you have completed the first stage of the pipeline. You can start stage 2 when ready to test it on a larger group of devices. To inform the users, we can push a notification to all devices once the update is done. This is accomplished by simply going to the Compliance Policy section. Compliance policy is a set of permissions related to the device configurations that can be applied to devices managed by Esper. Select New Policy. Give it a name and description. We want to enable the notification bar. If you are not sure about a specific setting, hover over the text and you will see a description of what it is, like this. When done, click Create Policy at the bottom. Then go back to the device page, go to Compliance Policy, select a new policy from the drop-down menu, and choose the notification bar we just created. Apply Policy. Give it some time to deploy the policy. You can always go to the event feed here to see if your request has been executed successfully. Weird. It is showing that one device is out of the range. Andy must have set up a geofence on the devices. Quick note, geofence is a function embedded in the device to set up a geographical functioning range. In this way, you can trace and monitor the device's location to make sure it is in a reasonable range at all times. Let's see what Andy has set up. It shows here that the geofence radius was previously set to 5 miles around Bellevue, Washington, and to lock the device once it gets out of the range. Suspecting a device loss, upon receiving this alert, Andy wants to quickly wipe the data from the device in order to avoid unauthorized use. Go back to the device detail page. Now select settings, select remove or factory reset. You have the option to factory reset the device and wipe external storage. Then click remove device. Congratulations! You have successfully factory reset this device and protected your data. Great job! With Esper's full service solution, Andy has provided a delightful experience for the patients. Esper would love to hear your business problems. Feel free to reach out anytime.